Welcome back, guys. In our latest tutorial, we crafted a risk matrix in Power BI using the default matrix visual. Today, get ready to elevate your data game as we supercharge this matrix to seamlessly interact with slicers without compromising its structure. Plus, we'll tackle the pesky empty cells background issue. But before we dive in, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with latest advanced BI and data science projects. Now, grab a cup of coffee, sit back and watch. Okay guys, in the previous video we have created this risk matrix. We have used the default matrix visual and we customize it to show number of risks based on the colors and risk categories. Now if you remember, we discussed that this matrix had some limitations. One important limitation was if we don't have a value of, or if we don't have a risk in this category that is negligible and rare, it will show blank, so it will not be color coded. Another issue with the filters: if we filter this matrix, for example, for one of the risks, it will filter the whole matrix, so the matrix will lose the structure. So let's, for example, add a slicer and feed in the risk categories to it. Let's just quickly format it, place it properly. So here we have the same idea. If we use the slicer to filter the matrix, you'll see we'll have more empty cells. And here it loses actually the structure because we don't have any data for the columns 1 and 4. So the idea is we want to create a matrix today that it doesn't change its structure and also it doesn't have uncolored cells. Even if the cell is empty, I still want to see this green, and so on. So let's see how we're going to do this. First, let's duplicate this page and let's rename it to Advanced Risk Matrix. We go to Modeling and we create a new table. So click New Table. We're going to create a DAX table based on our data. I have it ready, I'll just paste it. So what we're going to do, those are all the options available in the matrix. 1-1 is basically belong to this cell, 1-2 to this cell, and so on. So now we added all the available options. Then we cross join it with all the risk categories available. This will create a table for us, contains all the possible values. All you need to do now, hit commit, and we can see now a new table has been created. Let's go have a look. Here we go, we have the cell number is added and all the categories are added. So this repeated for each of the categories. Next, we're going to add some calculated columns to use this table for our matrix instead of the original table. Let's see how we're going to do this. Let's start by creating the rows and columns headers. Just right click on the table we just created, new column. I have the value ready, I'll just paste. We're here taking the right, which is the first value, belongs to the likelihood. And based on this value, if it's equal to 1, as you can see here, we're going to have rare, if it's 2, unlikely, and so on. Let's just hit commit. So now we have the rows headers. Let's repeat for the columns headers. So again, right click, new column. This is again the same for the columns headers, but this time we take the left value, which is this value, the second value, and we provide based on the number the corresponding name plus the number. Hit commit. So now we have the columns and rows headers. Next, we're going to create a column to give us the score, which is the multiplication of the first value and the second value. So right click again, new column, paste. So it has the left value, times the right value from this column. Hit commit. So now we have the scores. Next, I want to create a column to use it as a link between this table we have just created and the risk table. We're going to simply have a new column again and have the category dash the risk status temporary. So those two columns combined to give us a link. We're going to create now the same column but for the risks, and we'll use it as a link between the two tables. So let's do that for the other table too, risks. So right click, new column, and just paste. Again, takes the category and multiplies this number, the consequence, by the likelihood, and hit commit. So now we have our link. We can go now to model view, and now we can create a relationship based on the column we just created in both tables, the risk status. Here we go. I just want to make this both directions, so both tables will filter each other, and hit OK. Now let's go back to our risk status table. Now I'll create the most important column that will help us to understand why we have done this, which is counting the risks from the main risks table for each of the cells across the different categories. Let me create it first. Right click, new column. So the total risks will be counting the risks reference number, which is this number, and we'll filter it based on the status. We want the status in this table equals the status in the other table. Let's hit commit. Here we go. So the idea is, the reason we created this table, even if we have a cell belongs to a category that doesn't have any risks, we still have a value equal to zero. And this is the reason we added a zero at the end. So we always have a record. This will prevent the slicers to filter out those options from the matrix. We'll see in a minute how this is going to work. Now we want to create the color column. Let's right click, new column. Just similar to what we have done for the main risks table. It's based on the score here. If it's less than 3, we give it the green, and so on. Hit commit. So we have the colors ready. Now we have all the data we need. Let's go back to our report view and update this matrix. Basically, we want to replace these values from the new table we have created, starting by the rows header. Let's remove the old one. The columns headers, removing the old one. Let's rename this just like before to risk matrix. Here we go. And finally, the values, and we're going to use the total risks. So here we go. Just place it here, but instead of count, we're going to use now sum. So now you can see we don't have any empty cells, and we are going to deal with the zeros in a minute. Let's just reformat this and apply the conditional formatting from cell element. We're going to turn on background color again. Select conditional formatting and apply field value based on the color column we just created. Here we go. Click OK. You can see now the colors showing everywhere. And what we need to do now to size them properly, just like before, because we have changed the value, we have lost the formatting. But we can easily format this again. Let's also put these values in the center from specific columns. select sum of total and alignment to the center. We can also sort it again to have the green on the bottom, as you can see here. So now if you're not happy with seeing zeros here because they don't add any value to our risk matrix, it's better to hide them. We're going to use conditional formatting, but by applying the same color of the background to the value. But we want this to work only for zeros. So first we need to create a measure that applies the colors for zeros only. So new measure, I have the value ready, I'll just paste. So if sum of the total risks equal to zero, then use the same color code we created earlier. So hit commit. Now we can go to cell elements, but this time we apply conditional formatting to the font color. Click conditional formatting, field value, this time search for zero color, measure, and click OK. So as you can see, we don't see the numbers anymore. The zeros are hidden because they have the same color of the background. But before we test it, we need to also to update the fields from the risk category. Here we want to take the categories from the new table. Let's just replace them. Here we go. So now you can start testing it. Let's look for any of the categories. You can see we have the full matrix, but the numbers are updated. Here we go. And again, it works with this table. So if you select this specific risk, it will be filtered in the risks matrix. Here's another example, and so on. So now you have your risk matrix ready. You can embed it in your projects and do risk analysis in Power BI.